Hello and welcome to another NetIQ Unplugged video. My name is Chris Barngrover. I'm a strategist on the IAM product leadership team. Today we're going to be talking about the NetIQ IAM platform and the services and components that are included in that platform. Just to give you a quick run through an explanation essentially of the platform and the pieces that are involved. Now to start with, in the IAM portfolio, we've got a series of products and services that fall into multiple reporting markets from the analyst's point of view, right? Including products in access management, identity governance and administration, and privilege management. And we'll go into each one of these in a little more detail in following slides. But just to give you a sense for some of the key differentiators right off the bat is our approach is a common understanding of what is an identity, a common understanding of reporting and analytics, shared risk service, shared user self-service utilities, shared cloud bridge for SaaS hybrid communication capabilities, and leveraging a common identity foundation and a common construct and understanding of what is an identity and a resource. As opposed to, if we're doing this with a point solution, then each one of those will have a different construct, will have its own reporting and analytics, will have its own, you know, way and how it talks about and treats identities. So one of the real strengths here, again, is it's a common construct and a common understanding of what these things are and what they're made of, right? And then we go to market both in the workforce identity and the customer identity markets, right? So the typically much more complex, much more involved, when we talk about logic and data manipulation and the sheer number of systems involved on the workforce identity side, and the usually easier use cases, simpler use cases, less systems involved, but much more massive scale involved in customer identity. Now we go to market with identical products, no change on both of those, into both of those markets, as opposed to, again, some of our point solution competitors, which will fundamentally shift how they operate in one versus the other. So this is our story. These are our differentiators. Common construct and shared identity foundation, and going to market with a common product across all use cases, common in the identity space, both workforce and customer. So if we look first at Access Manager, the products and services involved here, you know, as we go across, starting with Access Manager, this is our traditional single sign-on web single sign-on product. It handles, you know, web single sign-on, handles federation, handles a lot of legacy sign-on and complex, much more complex sign-on use cases via browser-driven access. Really massive scale, some great success stories along this. You know, entire countries run access to their tax portals or to their social services with this infrastructure. One of our newer products is Secure API Manager, the same construct as Access Manager with, you know, risk-enabled and risk-aware access and authentication and authorization, but applying that level of protection to your APIs, which is one of the most popular threat vectors for attacks these days. Advanced Authentication, our multi-factor product here, is world-class, got some phenomenal success stories, great replacements of competitors in this space, some very large wins, global brands with global deployments, you know, failover region to region, the best method support, the most broad method support and of anything in the business, and as well as the ability to rapidly turn and add methods as needed. Some of the more recent ones are supporting government ID in systems to where you can now include the issuance or the verification of government ID when issuing a credential along those lines. And last but not least, SecureLogin, our traditional client-based single sign-on tool. With more and more products going web-based, the space for this is still, there's still a lot of leveraging going on here with the idea of, traditional or mobile workforces that are sometimes in the office, sometimes out. I need to store the credentials locally. There's a really strong hybrid, kiosk offering take SecureLogin and Advanced Authentication and bundle them together. Very popular kiosk offering in healthcare, to where a provider can come into the kiosk in a patient's room and you know, tap their badge in, and SecureLogin's fast desktop switching will load their desktop for them in just seconds, and it'll follow them from room to room. So there's some really still strong plays for client-based single sign-on tools, specifically in certain industries where there's shared workstations. Also driven out of this group is our self-service password reset, which is the user self-service utility. It does much more than just manage passwords, but it does that very well. It's also user account registration, account claiming, help desk integrated services, user self-service from a not just password, but from information self-service as well. So a lot of capabilities in that, as well as the shared risk service, which is a externalized shared service. Originally was the embedded risk engine within Access Manager. It's now a shared service across identity and access management, and is on the roadmap for some products actually outside of NetIQ across other pillars of CyberRes soon. So that's the Access Manager view. Identity governance and administration. To start with here, we will have our traditional identity manager product. It's been around for a very long time, scales to the moon. Along with Access Manager, there are entire countries that are run on this, and some massive customer-driven identity management solutions as well. One of our customers is well north of 50 million objects under management. And as I said, there are, you know, countries of 30, 40, 50 million people that run on this as well. Identity governance, this is your visibility, who shows who's got access to what, and automation, and making much more operationally efficient the required certification of who's got access to what, as well, you know, heavily driven analytics, heavily analytically driven guidance on users. Hey, you have one of your employees that has access that none of the other ones do. This is where you need to put your focus, you know, bubbling up the things to the end user that really need human attention, and giving guidance and suggestions on not just the approval side, but the suggestion side as well. And lastly, data access governance. This is the identity enabled data visibility and data governance tools. Some really strong offerings from Voltage on the data encryption point of view, but without the construct of identity, then monitoring who's touching what in the data world is only part of the view. So it's a really strong crossover there with our Voltage data encryption brothers in the CyberRes space, but all about, again, tying together from an identity level, not just an account level, but understanding which accounts are related to a common identity. And now I can get a bigger, more cohesive picture of who's doing what with what data. The shared identity foundation we mentioned earlier is a service driven out of this group, as is the Cloud Bridge communication service. And we also, in the privilege management space, we have our privileged account manager product. This is a traditional PAM offering, you know, the over the shoulder type, really high risk users, really high risk systems. I want a much more tight control and visibility of what's happening, you know, keystroke monitoring and recording, session recording, you know, active session monitoring, being able to work on both a credential checkout and a credential escalation paradigm. Either model works fine with this product. Being able to see and integrate requestable objects with, you know, other things in the stack, like identity manager, data governance, that sort of thing. Seeing and understanding what's happening is another strong play here. And lastly, our identity platform as a service. So this is where we are taking the future of identity and access management, is the ability to have not just taking our products as they exist to a SaaS deployment, but a platform as a service. And then the customer will spin up the services they need. Like, I want the federation service, I want the multi-factor service, I want the governance service, et cetera, and spin up the services you want within a common cohesive platform. Again, built upon the shared identity foundation and shared services that are available commonly across the platform. I thank you very much for your time, and look forward to the next time we speak.